Hey guys, welcome back to the next video, and this time we're back with another case for you. This time it's a micro ATX, so this one is called the CiT Eclipse. It comes with fans, it's a dual chamber, and it's got a panoramic glass on the top as well as the side. So let's get into it, shall we? Okay, so here's the case, and as you can see, it's a very small case. It's a micro ATX case. Now, as for the panoramic glass, as you can see, it's glass everywhere. I really like that look. That looks really nice. So, in terms of the I.O., now, it does have a power button, a reset, two USB 3, and headphone and microphone jack. Back of the case, now, it does have three included ARGB fans. The does have five PCI slots, and of course that's where the power supply goes, and obviously it's got captive thumb screws everywhere, so it, no need for actually a screwdriver. So let's get this side panel off now and then we'll have a look at the case. That comes off very nice, very nice tempered glass, very popular at the moment. So here we go. Like I said, it's a micro ATX, so it does support micro ATX, IATX, and ooh, look, it's got RGB on the top. Yeah, that's cool. So like I said, it comes with three included fans. These are like the infinity mirror type fans. But here on the sides, it's got quite a good ventilation. It looks like it would support a 360 at the bottom, but I would suggest putting fans under there, to be honest. That's where the most airflow is going to come. So now, it looks like it doesn't support like BTF or the hidden cable motherboards, but it's a £60 case. What do you really expect? But other than that, it looks really nice. You can support a 240 by here, or looks like a 280. But other than that, so yeah, let's have a look at the back. First of all, we need to take the top glass off, which are captive thumb screws, which is nice. And then this just slides off like that. Just like that. And that's the top panel, which is obviously like a little catch there, which is very cool. I like this dual chamber look. Now, other than that, I mean, actually, it's not bad. It doesn't feel bad. It actually feels okay. The overall quality is not bad. But, I mean, for £62, I believe it is, can't really moan, to be honest. Okay, so that's not bad, actually. Right, so here we go. Now, yes, it does actually come with an included ARGB controller, which can support up to, looks like, six PWM fans. So that's six fans. It does support up to six, so that'll be for three in the bottom. Now, as you can see, these fans are actually pulling air through, which isn't the best cooling. For cooling, you're better off having these push air in instead of out, but there seems to be ample room in the back, and to be honest, for the price point, I think it's actually a good, not bad actually, it's not bad for the price point. So let's get something built into this now. I'm going to AMD 7900 bar CPU, I'm going to put it into a micro ATX case, I'm going to put my RX 7800 XT in here and see how it actually performs. We'll be right back. Okay, so I've done two different types of tests. One with the fan standard on orientation, the way you would get it outside of a box, the way of them pushing air out the back instead of pulling air through the back. So I've done two different types of tests, one with Time Spy Extreme for 30-minute run, and then one with CINEBENCH R23. So for the RX7800XT, Time Spy Extreme, the 30-minute run, this is fans out of the box standard, and the GPU temperature was 26 Celsius, the junction temp was 54, and the hotspot was 34. That is the idle temps. Now, for the max temps, the GPU temp did go up to 49 Celsius with a junction temp of 73, and then the hotspot is 76 Celsius. So we'll stick to that first. Now, for Time Spy Extreme, with the fans turned around, so that means the fans pulling air in instead of pushing it out. Time Spy Extreme for 30 minutes, the idle GPU temps were, GPU temp was 24, the junction temp was 42, and the hotspot was 24 Celsius. So for the max temps, the GPU temp was a max of 50 Celsius, the junction temp was a max of 70, and the hotspot was a max of 74 Celsius. So for CINEBENCH R23, this is with the fans standard outside of the out of the box. The CINEBENCH R23 run was for 10 minutes, and the cooler I'm using is the Dark Rock Pro 5 from B-Quartz. The idles were 35, the max it hit was 89 Celsius. And then, of course, when it comes to like the fans turned around, pulling air inside the case instead of pushing it out, the CINEBENCH R23 idles were 34 with a max of 84 Celsius. Now, I've done another test for FURMARK, and this will be for a 30-minute run for the RX7800XT. So the idle temps were 24, that's for the GPU, the junction temp 48, and the hotspot 30. Now for the max, this was the normal standard orientation with the fans. The GPU highest temp it went was 55 Celsius, the junction temp was a 76, and the hotspot was a 78. So when it comes to the fans being turned around, the idle GPU temps were 24, the junction temp was 48, and the hotspot was 30. Now for the max temps was 54, the max of the junction was 76, and hotspot was also 76 Celsius. Okay, so you saw the rest of the video, you saw the thermals, you saw the overall first look in the beginning. Now what I will tell you is this does support big GPUs. As you can see, this is my RX7800XT Nitro Plus. This is a big card. I believe it's about 11 to 12 inches long. It's a big card. It's not small. It's a big card. So this will essentially fit a very big 4090 card, and it does have ample room for that. Now, the CPU cooler height, what I will tell you is that when I did the testing with this, I did have to push the glass up against this, so it was hitting this, but the max cooler height, I wouldn't go with a Dark Rock Pro 5. I did this because I like to do air cooler testing when it comes to case testing, because it will give you a better result instead of AIO, because you this is where the air is going from here to there. So yeah, now it has ample room for the cables. Now I do like the RGB. The RGB is actually fantastic. The effect, I mean, look at that little bar on the top. It looks amazing. I love the RGB. Now, yes, it does come with an included controller. You can have it connected up to your motherboard, or you can have it connected up to the reset. Now, this does have loads of different RGB functions. It's absolutely bonkers for what you get for the money these days. And just look at that. It's crazy. It's got so many different type of effects. The fans included, of course, do have that mirror, RGB and mirror effect on the sides. I do really like this case. I think for £62, it's an absolute bargain. And I honestly, if I was going to go with a smaller form factor than standard ATX, I'd seriously consider buying this for myself, because I think for what you get the RGB included, the fans. You also get an RGB controller that can control up to 6 fans. But obviously, because it's connected through SATA, it could be daisy chained up to more, which I find very, very good for this kind of price point. And it does support, obviously, big power supplies, but obviously there's going to be a length exception, of course. Now, CPU coolers, of course, that's exactly the same. I wouldn't exactly put a Dark Rock Pro 5 in here. I would go with an AIO and put it on the side, because it does look like it supports a 240 or a 280 millimeter AIO, so it would look fantastic. And obviously the panoramic glass looks absolutely amazing as well. So yeah, look, if you want to buy this case, honestly, this gets my recommendation. I would buy this for myself if I was going MATX, but obviously I'm ATX, I'm a bit more old school, but this certainly gets my recommendation for the price and for what you actually get for that price. So yeah, make sure you check the link down below and make sure to leave a link to this, because this is a fantastic case for the price point. And a big thank you to CIT. And as always, I hope you guys have a fantastic weekend and week ahead of you. Don't forget to subscribe, because I have got loads of stuff coming here. I've got loads of stuff here, products. I've got Joy Shark, I've got Deep Cool, I've got more AIOs, more CPU coolers, I've got a different case. So make sure you subscribe. And this is Richard from WELSHYTECH. Goodbye.